Hey guys, it's B-Raider 112345, and I'm going to be doing a one-time only broadcasting a NFL game. So I hope you enjoy.
Too tight for this play. Now first and 10. They give it to the running back. And that's a 2-yard gain.
Now this early in the game, to watch the opposing offense march down the field and get inside the 20. This keeps the defense, they might be shaking a little, but if they stop them here to a field goal try or worse, that'll get their confidence back.
tight end formation. This is a five-step drop back. Looking to the right side as well. And he's pushed out of bounds.
Well, this is a big confidence for the offense, isn't it? To boot down the field early in the game and get inside the 20. Let's see if they have a play up the sleeve that can get them in the end zone. Formation for the defense here. Third and nine. Looks around, under pressure, and incomplete. That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
I recall when Christian Ponder was drafted a quarterback, there's the 12th overall selection. A lot of people said, hey, you always respected this big McLaurin stick.
Yeah, and you know, I'll tell the truth here, I still thought he was there. I did not think he was going that high in the draft. The big surprise about Christian Ponder is the fact that, you know, I didn't see any throws when he's at Florida State, but he comes to the Minnesota Vikings, and I've seen him, I watched the guy fire down the field, and is really, I think that's the biggest surprise about Christian Ponder is how well he's throwing the football.
I look at this Lions offense, Calvin Johnson can't help but stand out.
There's not enough nicknames for Calvin Johnson. When you look down the field, you can pick him out right away. You cannot believe somebody this big and this fast can be a wide receiver in the NFL. He is truly special.
Offense lines up here. Tight ends in motion here. Snap back to the quarterback. Out of the gun. No separation at all. As we look at the defensive lineup, Jared Allen is a guy who can make a difference.
Jared Allen just doesn't get enough credit for how good he has been in the NFL with the Kansas City Chiefs and with the Minnesota Vikings. The speed, relentless, everything you want in a pass rusher.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. The quarterback drops back, play action. The Detroit Lions now move the chains.
That time it was an easy completion for the quarterback on the play-action pass, and it fools the defense because look how aggressive the offensive line is. They sold the play to the defense, and the quarterback took advantage.
Extra weight out there for this jumbo set. First and 10. Play fake here. Trying to work the middle of the field.
Not much you can say about that incompletion. The receiver was open. Quarterback just made a bad throw. Good decision, but a terrible throw.
Ends on the field here. Second down and 10. Here's the quick toss to the running back. They tackle him for a loss. Formation here for the defense. Third down and 13. He's looking to the right here. On this low.
Man-to-man coverage that time. Shut down the receiver. Really, the only way to do it is to man up and play a one-on-one.
We had the chance in 2011 to see Stafford, what he can do when he's healthy, and it was pretty dynamic.
Yeah, I think that it's been not a surprise because he was the first pick of the draft. But a couple things that have jumped out at me. His throwing, of course, there's no disappointment there. But he could run around a little more than I thought he could. And I watched him at Georgia, I didn't see it. He has shown some pretty good mobility here in the pros.
Not where you want to begin a series. Back up this team. It's handed to the running back.
This team is definitely committed to the run. There's no doubt about it. And when you're committed to the running game, hey, a lot of them are not going to work. That's okay. Stay with it.
Thank you.
To the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8. Toss to the outside after a 5-yard gain. Defensive back. Quarterback dropping back, looking to get the feet planted. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down. What a job by the quarterback, finding a way to throw that football and pick up another first down. They are marching down the field right now. Gave them the first down. Looking long. Throwing incomplete. The defense comes out in the nickel. Tight end in motion. The formation here, shotgun. Breaks free. The quarterback will protect himself here as he slides forward. The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. Now first and ten. Taking off. Gains five.
Well, that was a nice run that time. Ball tackle. This is a bread and butter play in the NFL. It's about power running. Can your offensive tackle make the block? To free up that running back so he has a chance to get that secondary and make a nice run out of it. This will be the eighth play of this drive. Tossing it to the running back. They deck him in the backfield. About to snap it. For the ninth play of the drive. Throwing out to his left. Touchdown! Well, one play for the touchdown, yes. And I'll tell you, in the NFL, there's so many players on offense now, you can never have enough points. So keep padding on that lead. Good job. Good score. And we're going to have a stoppage here because the food wants to have a look at this potential touchdown. So we've got a challenge, and the referee will go under the hood to determine if he got both feet down in the end zone with possession of the football. This is a tough call. It's so close, and as we watch the replays, I still don't have a clear decision on what I would do if I was the official. He's got his work cut out for him.